Hello, my name is Chinmay Patel and I am an applications engineer with the automotive business unit at Maxim Integrated. Today I'll be presenting our new fully integrated 4-channel white LED backlight driver, the MAX25512. So let me start with an overview of the product's features. MAX25512 is an automotive 4-channel white LED backlight driver with integrated current mode boost converter. MAX25512 operates over a switching frequency range of 400 kHz to 2.2 MHz. It is capable of providing 120 milliamps of output current through each current sync channel and includes control output for NMOS series switch for input current protection instead of PMOS switch, thereby saving cost. MAX25512 supports input voltages as low as 3 volts after the startup. It also includes an I2C interface, making MAX25512 solution easy to use for setting and diagnostics. A standalone device is also available. It is the MAX25510. MAX25512 includes PWM dimming with dimming ratio of 16,666:1 at 200 Hz. Hybrid dimming feature included in the device helps in dimming ratio, EMI, and acoustic noise reduction. Phase shift and spread spectrum can further enhance the EMI performance. Along with the above features, the device also supports various diagnostic functions such as boost output undervoltage, overvoltage detection, LED open short detection on each current sync, short to ground detection on each current sync, thermal warning, and shutdown. This is a typical application circuit for MAX25512 with 120 milliamps of LED current through each string and switching frequency of 2.1 MHz. It's powered from a car battery with an input voltage range of 5 volts to 18 volts. It supports 1 to 4 strings of up to 10 high brightness LEDs. This is a very small size solution with a very low BOM cost. Selecting boost inductor. The value of the boost inductor is determined using the following formula. A good compromise between the size and loss is to select LIR value from 0.3 to 0.6. Using an LIR value of 0.3, the calculated inductance value is 2.4 microhenry, and selecting the nearest standard value of 2.2 microhenry. Also remember to select the inductor such that the inductor's saturation current rating exceeds the maximum current limit rating of 6 amps. Selecting output capacitor. The function of the output capacitor is to limit the converter's total output voltage ripple to 250 millivolts peak to peak. To ensure stability of the boost output, connect multiple low ESR ceramic capacitors in parallel. A total output capacitance of 30 microfarad is a good starting point. Selecting feedback compensation components. The compensation components R-comp and C-comp perform two functions. C-comp introduces a low frequency pole that presents a minus 20 dB per decade slope to loop gain. R-comp flattens the gain of error amplifier for frequencies above the zero formed by R-comp and C-comp. The R-comp resistor value is calculated as follows. Based on the above formula, the calculated R-comp value is 52.9 kΩ and the nearest standard value is 53.6 kΩ. Whereas the C-comp capacitor value is calculated as follows. Based on the above formula, the calculated C-comp value is 0.73 nanofarad and the nearest standard value is 0.75 nanofarads. For more information on design parameters, please refer to MAX25512 datasheet. Let's get familiar with the MAX25512 EV kit. This is the MAX25512 IC, boost input capacitors, boost inductor, boost output capacitors, boost output, out current sync channels, and the MiniQ USB connector pin for I2C communication. For more information on the EV kit, please refer to MAX25512 EV kit datasheet. The EV kit also includes a Windows compatible software that provides a user-friendly GUI for easy setting and diagnostics. The software GUI has two main tabs. The first tab, MAX25512A, has controls for fast or slow soft start, boost converter and phase shift enable switches, low dim mode detection tabs, analog dimming setting, PWM frequency setting, shorted LED threshold setting, spread spectrum settings, out current sync channel disable switches, external and hybrid dimming controls, LED fading settings, and the fault detection panel. The second tab, MAX25512B, has dimming control for all out channels combined, dimming control for out one channel, dimming control for out two channel, dimming control for out three channel, and dimming control for outflow channel.
Now, let's see some performance results of MAX25512. Following are the results of a cold cranking event. As you can see, MAX25512 can withstand input voltages as low as 3 volts for a 100 millisecond duration after startup without losing regulation on the boost output voltage.
The MAX25512 also features fading in and out functionality, enabling the fading in and out setting from the GUI and setting the TDIM value to 4, turning on the LEDs and turning the brightness of the LEDs from 100% to 0%. And back at 100%. I'll be keeping a screen on the LEDs to dim it for the camera. As we can see, the LEDs are slowly fading out and fading in. The MAX25512's thermal performance is best evaluated with a thermal imaging gun. At input voltage of 12 volts, the part's case temperature is 45 degrees Celsius. And at input voltage of 5 volts, the part's case temperature is around 56 degrees Celsius. So even at 85 degrees Celsius ambient temperature with input voltage of 5 volts, the part's case temperature would be around 120 degrees Celsius, which is still below the maximum allowable junction temperature of 150 degrees Celsius.
For more information on MAX25512, please visit our website www.maximintegrated.com. Thank you for watching.